Good morning. I warmly welcome you all. Today, 6 January, our hearts are filled with gratitude as we celebrate the 10th anniversary of our founder, Monsignor Francis Xavier Croot. The life of this saintly missionary priest began in a little town called Zwolle in far off Holland. In just 46 years, who could have made such an impact on the society of his time? An impact which has transformed the lives of our brothers and sisters for the better. On this great day, let us pay homage to this great visionary through the act presented by our friends based on the life story of the servant of God, Francis Xavier Croot, who founded the Religious Institute of the Sisters of Our Lady of Fatima.
Francis Xavier Croot was born on 7 December 1854 as the youngest and the eighth child to his devout and God-fearing parents, Henry and Joanne Croot. The constant prayers of Mr. and Mrs. Henry Croot was, "Lord, may any one of our sons be a priest to serve you." And one extra decade of the rosary was practiced during family prayer for this secret intention that one of their children would receive vocation to priesthood. As a result, the three of their five sons became priests. Bartholomew Croot S.J. in African Mission. Anthony Croot, a Mill Hill Indian missionary. And Francis Xavier Croot, the youngest, followed his brother Anthony Croot. While Godfrey and John stayed at home to look after the family and the shoe manufacturing businesses. In April 1869 and later to Mill Hill, London for missionary life. After his ordination on 9th June 1878, Father Francis Xavier Croot followed his brother Anthony to India. Fulfilling the wish of their dying mother that the two brothers work together.
On 8th August 1878, Francis Xavier Croot, after a long voyage, landed at Madras seaport. Barely 24 years of age, Father Francis was appointed as the assistant parish priest at St. Mary's Cathedral. He mastered Tamil and was a chaplain at Punamalai for 2 years. Being one with the people, he began to think of a congregation of Indian sisters early 1882. And he thought to himself,
"Oh, could I build a nice convent here? It has been my all-absorbing thought ever since I came here."
Mission stations in India in different capacities, such as assistant parish priest at Punamalai in Madras, provincial of Mill Hill Missionary Society, assistant to his brother Anthony Crude at Ravipadu, Guntur district in Andhra Pradesh, Vice Provincial Rector and Professor at St. Joseph's Seminary at Nellore, Chaplain of Fort St. George in Madras, and editor of the English weekly The Catholic Watchman, presently known as The New Leader. Father Francis Xavier Crude was transferred to Bellary as the military chaplain and reached Bellary on the 9th of September 1882. Father Francis Xavier Crude encountered many spiritual, social and moral problems in his pastoral efforts in Bellary. During his pastoral ministry and in silent prayer, he realized the importance of education for all, especially education of women and girls, as they were given a very low status in society. He wanted to change their status and build up sound Christian families. Archbishop of Madras, Joseph Colgan, gave the formal permission to the request of Father Francis Xavier Crude to start the new Indian congregation of the Missionary Sisters of St. Francis Xavier Crude in Bellary in 1892. Thus, Father Francis Xavier Crude's dream came true on 8 February 1893. When three sisters, Sister Mary Andrew, Sister Mary Anna, and Sister Mary Clay, said yes to the will of God. These sisters were kept under the care of Good Shepherd Sisters in Bellary on request by Archbishop Joseph Colgan. June 1896 marked a memorable day in the history of Indian sisters when they were formally led to their own home, St. Francis Xavier Convent, Bellary at Kowal Bazaar. From then on, the sisters of St. Francis Xavier began the work of education of the Indian children of Bellary. Unfortunately, Father Francis Crude had only a rare glimpse of the infant congregation, as he was forced to leave India for better treatment due to his fragile health. The untimely death of Father Francis Crood on 5th January 1900 left the sisters orphaned. Death took him in his short span of life, but his dream of making women powerful in India to work for others did not die. Father Francis Xavier Crood MHM, a great Indian visionary and missionary, went unnoticed, unknown among the Indian missionaries for a long time due to lack of records. The sisters of Our Lady of Fatima faced many upheavals from all quarters as they dared to take a leap into the unknown.
Father Francis Xavier Crood's dream to return to India and be buried in the Indian soil became a reality when, in 1988, the Superior General of Fatima Sisters arranged to transfer his mortal remains from Hyres, France to India, and it is interred in the Chapel of Fatima Sisters, Chandelade in Pune. Monsignor Francis Xavier Crood has come back to his own children, his beloved India, to rest in the Indian soil, and he is our powerful intercessor before God. The servant of God, Francis Xavier Crood, is a great example for all of us. He is an inspiration for priests, missionaries, and for religious life. His outstanding piety and abiding zeal for missionary work is a perfect example for us all.